Hi everyone, this is Peter Wohlleben. I'm the author of Can You Hear the Trees Talking? And this is a little lecture for the Lighthouse Bookshop. So let's try with my rough English. And if it is too bad, you have always the opportunity to read your book yourself. Okay, let's start. I want to read the chapter, Is There a Forest Internet? Trees have no computers and no phone lines. Nevertheless, they are connected to each other, not just through their root systems. Beneath the leaves on the forest floor, other beings have made themselves at home, and they help the trees too. Until now, it hasn't been completely clear to scientists whether fungi are more like plants or like animals. Like animals, they feed on things they were or are alive. Some fungi eat the wood of dead trees, while others prefer old leaves. But there are also species that like to partner with living trees. These fungi help trees relay messages to each other. If one tree wants to say something important to another, it sends a liquid through its roots. Around the tips of the roots, the fungi have wrapped a soft, cottony web. This is where the fungi absorb the tree's message, and they pass it on through their fine threads. These threads run throughout the forest floor and connect the trees to each other, so that all of them can hear what the tree has to say. So, for example, if a certain kind of beetle begins to attack one tree, other trees can get the message and prepare for it. But fungi don't provide their service for nothing. Just as your internet at home has costs, trees also have to pay for their communication system. There may not be money in the forest, but there is something similar. Sugar. Sugar is the money of the forest. Everything in the forest is crazy about sugar, perhaps like you. Insects, birds, and fungi all love their sweets because they need sugar to grow. And trees grow their wood, leaves, and bark from sugar and from various kinds of salt. As we learned in chapter 1, trees make its sugar using their leaves and sunlight. Fungi demand up to one-third of the tree's total sugar production for their forest internet services. It's very, very expensive. One-third. That means for an average household, a human household, perhaps £1,000. That's very, 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 very expensive. But without the fungi, the trees wouldn't receive messages about imminent danger, so they pay the price. The fungi need the sugar not just because they are hungry and need to keep themselves alive, but also to produce their fleshy fruit, the mushrooms that sprout on the forest floor every fall. If you come across a porcini, canterelle or bay bolete mushroom, what you're seeing is converted tree sugar. I don't know if you have ever asked why those mushrooms came, the most mushrooms on the forest floor came up in autumn. That's because the trees had all the summer time to produce sugar and they are strong now. And in autumn it's payday. And then trees have to pay their internet. Then the fungi is able to produce mushrooms. So the fungal internet transports not only messages, but also sugar. If one tree wants to help another, it sends out a serving of sweets. But the fungi don't always do what the tree wants, no, no. Sometimes they pass on sugar to another species of tree, and trees don't like that. They only want to help other trees of their same species, or let's say their own family. The fungi are just playing it safe, so they don't care. It could be, for example, that one day the beech trees that they live with will all get some awful, awful beech disease and die. Then the fungi would die too, because they would have no more trees to supply them with sugar. So they secretly send some sugar juice to other tree species, such as oaks or birches, to make sure they stay healthy and fit. That way, if an illness breaks out among the beech trees, the fungi can offer their services to the oaks and birches and won't need to go hungry. Perhaps a quiz at the end of this little lecture. The fungal internet is spread over the whole forest floor. Fine white threads connect all the trees below the ground. If you scooped up a teaspoon of forest soil and put all the fungal threads you collected end to end, how far might they stretch? One answer might be maybe 1 inch. The other answer may be more than a yard. And the third answer may be more than a mile. How long is the are the fungal threads in 1 teaspoon teaspoonful of earth? And the right answer is more than a mile. They are so little, these threads, you can see them with your eye just under a microscope, but when you put them all together, they're longer than a mile. So the forest internet is very, very big. So if you want to have more fun, there's more fun in this book. And which is what is even more important is support your local bookstore. And don't buy books via internet. Support your local bookstore because we all have to stand together now. And I think when this crisis is over, our human society will be much stronger, like the society of trees. Bye-bye.